Hello, in this video I will show Finnish style handing an axle with the two snake wedges. So I have prepared two snake head shaped wedges beforehand. Then I have here firmly fitted axe handle, which is not done red yeti yet. And here I have markings, and I will then slice these with an chisel after I have fitted first the axe to the handle. So I have here old American style Billnäs axe. And I will now place it on. And it's done like this. And once the axe handle is around 2 centimeters on top of the actual axe, it's firmly placed, as you can see. And now I will slice the head with chisel. Now I have sliced this, and I will shape the corners. We will start this work with the knife. So it eases up the start of the penetration. Like this. Now I will start to hit the first wedge in, but before that I have to mark how deep I can hit it. So I will place here a marking like this, and also take the second wedge and mark it also. So you must not go deeper than the axe itself. And once I have it like this, I will start hit from the wedge. And now it's nearly next to the mark. I feel that it doesn't penetrate anymore, so I will cut the extra off here. Thank you. then I start to hit the second wedge. Now also the second wedge is in, and as you can see, the axe head has expanded greatly. Now I have the axe handle ready. So the handle is made from birch. I have boiled the portion of the handle around half an hour in the water to get it softer. So it enables that this wedges can penetrate to the wood. And also, once we are assembling this axe, it goes deeper in this direction since the wood is soft. Once you are hitting the wedges, you have to start from this side and hit this afterwards. And the benefits compared to traditional wedging with this snake head wedge are that now we can get the expansion to all the directions, since the axe eyes typically also expand like this. And the wedges I have made from this kind of a dried pine wood, so it's a bit softer than the birch. And once you are making this, the grains of the wedge and the handle have to be in same directions. If you are making a wedge for this kind of a traditional Finnish colored axe, so it's done with one wedge. And also in this case, we get the expansion to all the directions. Another benefit is that since this is heavily tapered, you can get around 1 centimeter deeper this axe to the handle. Although you have done a pretty good job, and this is already in the start very firm. And this axe handle I have made around 1 month ago. Although it was wet in the beginning, it's now dried. But because of this wedging, it's really firm and stays without loosening.